在我这个作品里面，其实，在我身上画春是一个技术问题，其实并不难。背景简单的话，可能几个小时就完成了。我可能更在意这个背景跟我的情感体验之间的某种关系，就是那种说啊，你被消失掉，你是为什么？你后背后的原因是什么？
刘Bolin is a hard man to find, literally. For 16 years, he's been hiding in plain sight in his artworks. He has earned international fame as a camouflage artist who paints his body to merge into physical environments. It all started in 2005 when his art studio in Beijing had to be demolished because it was on land meant for railways. He faded into the ruins and laid motionless for hours. That was the first of his now famous series titled Hiding in the City.
刚开始画颜色的时候，那会儿就因为年轻，什么都不怕，就往脸上直接画，因为用丙烯色，它也不怕干，一使点劲儿也能死下来。结果有一次在上海拍作品，那个赞助的是一个日本的颜色，我的妈！我洗了半小时，差点没洗下来。从那以后我就害怕了，而且那时候皮肤极其红，肿得很厉害，代谢不掉。然后呢，就慢慢的就会有一些面膜呀，包括有一些，就是画画以前就把像现在用凡士林啊、面膜啊，有些地方去保护一下。
Leo's work could start with a glance out of the window while driving. Once he spots an interesting location, he spends time figuring out the logistics, like when the place is least crowded and which days are cloudy. Leo can't work under direct sunlight, as his work should not have any obvious light or dark areas.
外拍的时候会遇到，比如说特殊的一些极端的一些物理情况，比如说像下雨啊、大风啊、低温啊，这都是些物理你不可控的一些东西。我在意大利的蓬佩古城拍的时候，就拍的马上就画完了，哗就下去了。那时候我第一个反应就先把相机找一个塑料袋，先把相机先保护起来。我淋了不要紧，相机受不了。
Over the years, Leo has created artworks around the world highlighting social issues and inequality. He says once his work leaves the studio and goes into a gallery, it becomes a piece of art or a commodity. But in the studio, it is only an emotion or catharsis.
比如说美术馆的馆长看我作品，他觉得你有对中国这段时间的一种社会性的，比如说艺术跟社会关系的一个总结很好。语言啊，包括背景和中国的发展啊，中国的历史一点点都可以看到。但是对于孩子来讲，他会在哪儿？这个人在这儿了，在那儿了。他不同的人群有不同的人的解读，可以啊。我觉得艺术没有必要非给说你，我非要给你怎么样。
Leo finds it hard to cast himself into a specific artistic archetype. In 2019.He participated in the Photography Biennale in Melbourne, where an Australian poet summarized his work into three P's: performance, photography, and painting. Liu says he quite liked that summary. The COVID-19 pandemic has had great impact on Liu. He spent several months in the studio buying lots of water, food, and alcohol to put on his shelves and turn it into his work.
不光是我个体，我觉得整个人类也重新好像都要经历一个和打碎和重新组装的一个过程。这种打碎和重建呀，是人类未来的一个主题。如果说咱们人类十年是一代的话，可能下一代人呢，可能又比我有更新的版本出来。我只是说尽我所能去做我的这种版本更新，重新建立一个所谓新的世界而已。